Hello, and welcome to our first example using Ksp values. We are going to solve the problem of calculating the molar and gram, or just solubility, gram solubility, of silver bromide. In this example, we are given the Ksp value of our gram, or of our silver bromide, and we want to solve for both the molar solubility and just the solubility. Remember the required steps to show your work in these solutions. Here we have our equation of dissociation or dissolution. Underneath that, we could set up an ice table. And on our next video, I'm going to show you shortcuts to avoid having to use an ice table. Remember that for our ice tables, solids and liquids are not included. The concentration of silver bromide won't be changing, so that can be set to zero. Sorry about that. Again, our initial quantities of our products are zero. Because those are zero, our reaction has to go forward. They will change by plus x, just a 1x because of the coefficient of 1, and therefore at equilibrium we have just x. The next step to set up is our equilibrium expression. Here we have the concentration of silver ion and the concentration of bromide ion, each first order, because of the coefficients of 1. Realize when we plug in our values at equilibrium, we have just x and x. And so our Ksp equation comes out to be x squared. Remember that we were given the Ksp value for this salt, and so we can set that equal to 5.0 times 10 to the minus 13. When we're asked to solve for molar solubility, that is the x value from our ice table. In this problem, because we have x squared equal to our Ksp value, we have this equation to solve, and we just take the square root of both sides, and therefore our x value would be 7. With extra digits, we have 7.07107 times 10 to the minus 7. And of course, remember that our x values in our ice table are molarities or concentrations. For a final answer, because our Ksp value only goes to 2 sig figs, if we're reporting this as a final answer, then we would round this as 7.1. times 10 to the minus 7 molarity. So that is our molar solubility. To solve for the solubility or gram solubility, this is a more useful unit to use in lab. Gram solubility is going to be reported in units of grams per liter. Again, more helpful in lab because we can actually measure how many grams of a substance we would have to measure out in order to get it to dissolve in a liter of water. Remember also that our units of molarity are moles per liter. To convert from molar solubility to gram solubility, we are using the molar mass of our salt to convert the moles to grams. For silver bromide, we calculate its molar mass by looking up each atom's molar mass. So silver is 107.87, bromide is 79.904. Again, a reminder to use the quantities on your blue periodic table here, especially for homework. Do not search Google for these numbers, or you will get slightly different values. In the homework, it'll be just different enough to be wrong. Our molar mass for silver bromide then is 187.774 grams per mole. So our last step in the calculation is to take our unrounded molar solubility. Here I'm going to include the written out units of molarity, moles per liter, so I can figure out how to use my molar mass for my final step. I need to cancel my moles and convert that to grams. So I'm going to include my molar mass on top and one mole on bottom. We carry out this calculation. Rounding to sig figs, we get a final answer of 1.3 times 10 to the minus 4 grams per liter. And those units don't simplify down. We leave it as grams per liter for our solubility. And so that is our final answer for that one. Rewriting this number, if you think about it, in decimal notation, what this gram solubility tells us is literally how many grams of the salt can dissolve in a liter of water at room temperature. Think back to the balances that you use in lab. These balances only go to 4 decimal places. And so it means literally if I put pretty much just one crystal of silver bromide on the balance, that's about the mass that I would have here, that is all that would dissolve in a full liter of water at room temperature. And so that indicates to us that this salt is not soluble. Again, noticing our Ksp value, 10 to the minus 13, that tells us this is not a soluble salt, and that gram solubility helps to verify that. So the smaller your Ksp, the smaller your molar and your gram solubility value should be. In our next video, we will talk about shortcuts, how to determine the shortcut for our Ksp equation so that we don't have to use an ice table for these.